last class we have worked out the entire problem, that is problem number 14, except the last line. You can see, prepare process cost account and abnormal gain or loss account. He is asking us to determine abnormal gain or loss. Now question arises, how to prepare abnormal gain or loss account? That we have to learn here. So we need to make rolling for the abnormal loss or gain account. And in each account you have to just, each of the accounts to be prepared just for 4 lines. How many lines? 4 lines you have to make the rolling. So what I suggest you, he is asking you to prepare abnormal loss or gain, but I also suggest you to prepare one more account by name normal loss account. You will get complete information about the problem. Please make rolling for 3 accounts. What are the 3 accounts? Abnormal loss account, abnormal gain account, normal loss account. Just how many lines? 3 lines. Each account is to be prepared for 3 or 4 lines, not more than that. Please make the rolling for 3 accounts. What are the 3 accounts? Abnormal loss, abnormal gain, normal loss. Make rolling. Yes, I'll explain to you. Normal gain, he is not asking you to prepare normal loss. But you will get clear idea if you prepare normal loss account also. Please observe the first account. Tell me whether there is abnormal loss or abnormal gain. Please observe the first
normal loss.
Abnormal loss. Abnormal loss. Please observe it carefully. Don't read it casually. Observe it carefully. Tell me whether there is abnormal loss or abnormal gain. First account, first process account. My question is whether, tell me whether it is abnormal loss or abnormal gain.
Normal loss or abnormal gain.
That is what I am asking. So before giving the answer, you have to listen to my question. What I say. Tell me whether there is abnormal loss or abnormal gain. The answer is, there is neither abnormal loss nor abnormal gain. So this particular account is not affected. This account is not affected. Now see the second process account. Is there any abnormal loss or abnormal gain?
Abnormal loss.
Abnormal loss. Yes or no? If you observe, that abnormal loss appears on the credit side of process account. Am I correct?
Yes.
Abnormal loss appears on the credit side of process account. Now for every credit, there should be a corresponding debit. Look at the board. Abnormal loss appears on the credit side of the process account. For every credit, there is a corresponding debit. In the abnormal loss account, on the debit side, we should write to process account. Please help me. How much is the units of abnormal loss in second process?
90?
15, sir. 15.
Rate
per unit?
20.
20. Holding cost?
300.
Because on the credit side of the cross account, you have buy abnormal loss. For every credit, there is a corresponding debit. So on the debit side of abnormal loss account, you should write to process to account. Because abnormal loss appears on the credit side of the cross account. That is why for that credit, we need to pass what's the debit aspect in abnormal loss account. Yes or no? Second one is though. See the third process. Third process. Abnormal loss or abnormal gain. Third process. Loss or gain. Third process you see. Abnormal loss or abnormal gain. Gain?
Yes, sir.
Abnormal gain,
sir. Abnormal gain. Abnormal gain appears on the debit side, you see.
Yes.
You're taking so much time to identify abnormal gain. Huh? Abnormal gain appears on the debit side of process account. Yes or no? So see, that process three account. On the debit side, you will find abnormal gain. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, for every debit, there should be a corresponding credit. So, on the credit side of abnormal gain, you should write by, in which process?
Three.
Process 3 account. How many units? 36.
36? Yes, sir, 36.
Rate per unit?
38.
38?
Yes, sir.
Total cost?
1368.
So, abnormal gain appear on the debit side of process 3 account. For that debit, we need to pass the credit aspect. For the debit, the opposite aspect is credit side. On the credit side of abnormal gain, you should write by process 3 account. Process 1, neither gain nor loss. Process 2, there is loss. Loss appear on the credit side of process 2 account. For the credit, we need to write on the debit side, opposite aspect. And in process 3, there is a normal gain on the debit side of process 3 account. For the debit on the credit side, we should write, on the credit side of abnormal gain, you should write by process 3 account. O. First, second, third, O. Next. Now you see the first process account. Is there any normal loss?
Yes, sir.
On which side? For every
credit,
there should be a corresponding debit. Look at the book. Normal loss appears on the credit side of process 1 account. Yes, sir. For that credit, we need to write on the debit side of the normal loss as 2 process 1 account. Tell me how much?
50.
Y 0?
Yes, sir.
Rate per unit?
50.
It comes to 100. Yes or no?
Yes.
Process 1 is finished. On the credit side of process 1, we have by normal loss. For that credit, we need to write on the debit side. Yes or no? Now, next, second one, process 2. Process 2, you see. Process 2. Do you find a normal loss on the credit side?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
For that credit, on the debit side of the normal loss, you should write 2. Process second account. How many units?
95.
95? Rate per unit?
4.
4?
3.
Last process, third process you see. Is there any normal loss in the third process?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So for that credit, on the debit side you should write 2. Process third account. Because abnormal losses are there on the credit side of the process accounts. So for that credit, we need to write the opposite aspect on the debit side of the normal loss. How much?
126.
Rate per unit?
5.
600. 600 and? So, normal, abnormal loss, abnormal gain and normal loss. How many accounts?
3.
We have prepared these 3 accounts with the help of process account. If you prepare the process account, then only you will be able to prepare what's in these accounts. See the subsequent aspects. Just look at the board. Don't write anything. Write afterwards. Abnormal gain units are 36. Yes, no talking, please. Abnormal gain units are 36. Abnormal gain is utilized to reduce the normal loss. I repeat, units of abnormal gain is utilized to reduce which loss? Normal loss. How? Let's see. In third process, you are getting abnormal gain. So, abnormal gain is what it is utilized to reduce which loss? Normal loss. How to deal with this item? Let's see. On the debit side of abnormal gain, you should write to normal loss. How many units are there? 36 units. It is in which process?
Third
process. See the rate per unit of the normal loss. Third process, rate per unit is how much?
5.
36 into 5.
180.
180. to normal loss. And on the credit side of the normal loss, we should write by abnormal gain. How many? 36 units. Valued at the rate of 5. 180. Exactly.